Hold up. Yeah. I got a God, don't change with the season. What is up, YouTube? Big C7 Cards here with another big time mail day video for you guys. The reason why it is big is because I got lazy. I'm sorry, guys. I finished the video for a recent mail day, but I didn't edit it. I didn't post it. Boo. I don't know. Just the time got away from me. And I haven't talked to you guys since the beginning of the NFL season, so you already know. All these times I've been talking about Drew Lock and the man's already injured. Man, he's going to be out a few weeks. He'll come back. Don't you worry about that. But yeah, this week was an absolute massacre in the NFL. Countless players got injured. Big names, too. Saquon Barkley is down. Drew Lock is down. Not a big name, but the first one that comes to mind. Brashad Perryman is down. Sterling Shepard is down. Byron Jones, the Dolphins' number one cornerback, is down. There were so many players who got injured in a single day, and I think really I'll save this for another video, but I think it has to do with the whole there were no OTAs, there were no preseason. You don't have a preseason when you're not prepared for real live football action. That's what happens. So anyways, to skip all of that, I could talk about that. I said I was going to be talking more about football soon, so I'll start trying to post some videos on that. But I want to get right into this. This is a double mail day, which means it's going to be double as fun. It's going to be huge. And I'm starting off with a bang. This is what I'm going to go in the exact same order that I did in the last video with the same stories and everything, all the fun stuff to go with it. And this one was a big one. 2019 gold standard, triple patch RPA, Drew Lock, 33 of 49. I got a heckin' good deal on this because there was some damage at the top right there. But that I don't really mind. A little crease above the first patch there. But it's still a really nice RPA, and I didn't mind. It wasn't part of the item description, and so I certainly got a partial refund on it, but it's still something really nice. What's crazy is my lock collection has really taken off, and people are starting to panic sell their Drew Locks now, to say the least. Prices are going down, dropping, people are getting terrified that they have missed the boat on their investment. But I guarantee you guys, just wait it out. Don't sell your locks. Don't freak out. He's still a second year quarterback with a lot of potential. He hit his shoulder and his throwing arm, so that's tough, but he'll come back, no doubt. The Broncos have no other choice. They got Jason Driscoll at quarterback right now, who actually played well. Okay, to Driscoll's I'm not going to bash on Driscoll, but they need Lock back. And speaking of Lock, I pulled this one out. It might be a little hazy because I have a penny sleeve on top of the card inside the One Touch. But this is a gold legacy Drew Lock rookie auto out of 50. Gotta love that one. And next on the list. Okay, here's a story time. So I went to my local Walmart, Okay, my local Walmart. You're gonna see some pictures and videos pop up any second now, from my Instagram at BigC7_cards. If you're not following me, go follow it right now. But recently, I went to my Walmart and I decided, you know what? People are being crazy and doing stupid things. Why not I do it too? I got on my hands and knees, guys, and I looked underneath the card shelves because obviously there's nothing there. Everyone scavenged all the cards from my card shelf in my local Walmart, but all the way in the back underneath the shelf, all sticky and nasty, covered in gelatinous COVID-19, I found a pack of 2018-19 NBA hoops. Here's a picture of how nasty it looked when I pulled it out of there. When I pulled it out, it made that nasty sound like when you pull a you know those pennies that are on the ground that are stuck to gum and you try to pull them off and it goes like that. That's what it sounded like. I still bought it. And wouldn't you know, there was a Trae Young in there. This Trae Young has been sitting underneath the card shelf in my local Walmart for 2 years now. Wouldn't you know? So I didn't get a Luka, but I got the consolation prize. I got a Trae Young, and I got a Jaren Jackson out of it. So a Trae Young and a Jaren Jackson. They're not reds. They're blacks, but they're still very nice. That's on the case. And I also pulled this out of the same pack. Get out the way, LeBron James and Faces of the Future, Marvin Bagley. So that was not bad at all. So a pretty sweet pack of 2018-19 NBA hoops, which is actually the first basketball cards I've opened since December of last year, by the way, because you can't find any to open, has been sitting under my card shelves the entire time. And it only took a pandemic to get me to look under there. Go figure. So that's the story behind that. If you want to see me open it, I opened it live on my Instagram. It's on my IGTV. Go check that out because it's there. And here's another cool story. First and foremost, go check this guy out. Chasing Rookies. That's his Instagram handle. Go follow him. He's a really cool guy. He recently did a giveaway, and this is what that is from. He gave away spots in a draft break. So how this worked was basically you had as many, you had 30 people won. So there are 30 teams in the NBA, 30 people won. And it was a random draft. So you have random draft picks. I picked 24th and you get to pick up one player and one team. And you get all the players on the team except ones that have maybe been picked in the past. So if somebody picked LeBron James and then you pick the Lakers, then you'll get Anthony Davis and all the other Lakers, Alice Caruso, whatever. Is it weird that the only other Laker I thought of immediately was Alice Caruso? Anyways, because he's the GOAT on the Lakers anyways. So I got Cam Reddish and the Spurs. And it turned out pretty well. I got all these cards for free out of it. So big shout out to him. Thank you so much. If you're watching this, that was a lot of fun, by the way. Doing the draft and strategizing, you know, paying attention to what everybody else was picking and seeing what my best options were. Like, that was a lot of fun. I love strategy. But that was a lot of fun. If you ever do it again, let me know. I'll be definitely in on it. But that was a lot of fun. Go check out Chasing Rookies on Instagram. But this is what I got. I got a My House DeMar DeRozan. I got a Winter Stays Timmy D, Tim Duncan. I got a pink Pulsar DeMar DeRozan, a pink Pulsar Rudy Gay. I did get a Quindary Weatherspoon, so fancy of a name, rookie optic. I got a Luka Semenic base and pink Pulsar with the no name. And I also got a Cam Reddish, but I just recently traded it to somebody, so I can't show it to you. Maybe I'll show you a picture. Boom, right there, picture. But this is what I got, and I got it all for free. So, and he shipped it out real nice. So thank you so much. That was big time. I had a lot of fun. You're the GOAT for that. And I got a Luka Pink Pulsar. Who knows? Maybe Luka Semenic turns out to be the next Luka Doncic. Like, if you could just change last names here, woo, I'd take that any day, wouldn't you? Wouldn't anybody? Next, I got an absolute, you know, I try not to, you know, to show my cards too much. Well, I show my cards all the time, but you know what I mean. Like, my strategy for buying cards. But this one, the guy posted it too cheap, I think. But let's just call it an eBay snipe, just between you and me. It is an absolute snipe. I won't tell you how much I got it for because you could probably look it up yourself. But how about 2019-20 Mosaic MVPs LeBron James number 298 PSA Mint 9. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. You know it's serious when you hear the crackling of the PSA. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. That's like that one episode of SpongeBob where he's rubbing the pickle. Yeah, if I can't find a video of that to put it in here, it's going to be really out of context. Whatever. Anyways, so yeah, that's Mosaic LeBron James, Mint 9. Good stuff. Moving on, I found a dude on eBay who had some Drew Locks. This was before he got injured, or I would have paid a lot less on this, but I am not at all upset about it. I'm going to be taking pictures of this very soon for my Instagram because it's just that nice and it needs to be in lights, camera action. How about a 2019 Spectra Drew Lock die cut 6 of 30. Boom. Beautiful. That is a green scope. I love these green scopes, guys. It doesn't give it justice because I have the penny sleeve in there. It is so beautiful. Make sure that you are following me on my Instagram because this is going to be highlighted in there very soon. I actually have a lot of pictures that I need to put on there. But I will do that soon. I just need to edit this video and get it out. Clearing out what I've done so far, guys. I'm going to clear all this out to move on to the next heat. Speaking of the Heat, glad you guys asked. The Heat are in the conference finals up 2-1 against the Boston Celtics. I'm calling it Heat in 5. I said that before the game they even started, so I did give the Celtics some respect. You know, some respect. They will win one game, but that's it. The Heat are going to win out. Tomorrow is the next game. I'm going to be watching it 8:30, I think, is the start time. But anyways, I am so excited. Moving on to the next one. It is not every day that you get a Rookie of the Year sent to your mailbox, and I got this one. How about a Panini Instant double-double in MSG Memphis Grizzlies debut PSA 9 from Panini Instant? And this is a crazy undervalued card. I think there were a couple of sold for $40. There's one on there, I think, right now for $40. If you're watching this, go and take it. I don't have the money for it, but if I did, I would take it. This is ridiculous. You got a Ja Morant numbered out of 150. 150, crazy low print. And it's just sitting there, not being bought. Like, I don't get it. I got this for cheaper than $40. But that's crazy to me. I think that these cards are going to, the ones that are low print number, because there are some of these that are like in the thousands made. And it's like one out of 3,000, one out of 4,000. I think they make as many as people buy in the pre-orders. But this should go up in price. Like, come on. It's a low-numbered Ja Morant. He's a Rookie of the Year, PSA 9. There is no reason why this card should be sub $40 right now. There is no way. And so for an investment, heck yeah. I'll take that. I'll sit it in my basement. I don't have a basement. I live in a condo. But if I had a basement, I'd sit it in the basement and just let it, you know, I just let it season. You know, let it season there. I don't get it. Another guy, I'll show you this one. Another guy that is not getting that much love right now in card values. I'm starting to sound like Jeff from Sports Card Investors. Is Trae Young. Trae Young, how about this with the Sparkle lottery ticket? That's a rookie. Come on. It shouldn't be this easy to get Trae Young rookies, and yet it is. Very easy, guys. I saw a Trae Young 1-of-1, a white box 1-of-1 rookie auto that sold for, I want to say it was $175 or two. It was less than $300. A 1-of-1. I'm sorry, that shouldn't happen. Not too long ago, people were saying, oh, I can't tell who got the better draft pick. Was it the Mavericks who took Luka, or was it the Mavs who took, or the Hawks who took Trae Young? There was a question. If that question was there not too long ago, there's no reason why Trae should be selling for so incredibly cheap when compared to Luka. Like, there's no way. There's no way. That does not make sense to me. Does not compute, and does not compute. Get you some Trae Young if you can, because that is not going to last that long. Let me set it so it's not reflecting my face for the next 5 hours. This video is not going to be 5 hours, by the way. I don't want to scare you guys. Unless you love hearing my voice for 5 hours. Another one that I've picked up. These are undervalued as well. I'm going to take it out of the case just for a moment, just to show you, because it doesn't give it justice inside of the scratched up case. I got a Bam Adebayo Go Heat Optic Holo rookie. Like, these should not be readily available. I should look at these and say, oh, heck no, I can't afford that. I'm just going to let somebody else buy it. I should be saying that right now, because Bam Adebayo is too good for his cards to be this cheap. And by cheap, it means I'm able to buy it. You know, I've been a retail warrior for years. Like, you know that my collection is not worth much outside of the what I buy from eBay. This should not be that cheap right now. This should be at least $150 each right now, but it's sitting around $80, $90 each. It's going to go up. You know, when the Heat win the championship, I'll quote myself on this, okay? The Heat are winning the championship this year. And if you don't believe that, then you probably were also the people who this on the same boat as the people who told me, oh, they're not going to make it past the first round. Oh, they're not going to make it past the second round. They're not going to beat the Bucks. No way. Oh, the Celtics are going to destroy them. We're 2-1 on the Celtics. We nearly swept the team with the best record in the entire NBA, the Milwaukee Bucks. Sweeping the Pacers was easy, but you get the point. His cards should not be that low. And the fact they are appalls me. But I got a lot more to show you guys, so I'm going to keep going without ranting on about Bam Adebayo and the soon-to-be NBA champion Miami Heat. Let's talk about some more Drew Locke. Obviously, the biggest one here, I recently picked up a Prism Drew Locke rookie, base rookie, which was a big-time pickup for me just because, for one, it's crazy cool. And for two, the value was like skyrocketing on them. Obviously, until he got injured, but he's going to come back. Come on. A few weeks doesn't hurt nobody, okay? Everybody thinks Julio Jones is the one of, if not the best wide receiver in the league. And look at all the time he missed. He missed a few games for turf toe, okay? He missed a lot of games for turf toe, actually, but he's missed a lot of games in the past few years. But he's still considered one of the best wide receivers, if not the best wide receiver in the NFL. Drew Locke's going to get his chance. Drew Locke has already shown that he can do some amazing things, and that's going to change. Y'all are going to think about Drew Locke very different very soon, in which case I'll be pulling up all of the messages that I've been getting from all these different people telling me that Drew Locke sucks and he's not going to do crap. So, I'll be coming for you later. But anyways, absolute Drew Locke rookie, introductions Drew Locke rookie, and a base from this. Actually, this is a second year Drew Locke. Got it just because I wanted one from 2020 Don Russ, which is going crazy right now. Prestige. The 2020 Don Russ is going crazy for various reasons. People are going crazy over players who have a good week. They have one good week and people freak out, which doesn't make sense to me, but they're still freaking out. And when they freak out, card prices go crazy, like Edwards-Hilaire. Clyde Edwards-Hilaire, one of his rookie autos out of 10, no, it was an RPA out of 10, sold for $1,000. What? Clyde Edwards-Helaire. He's a rookie. Nobody knew who he was. I'm not going to be exaggerating. Very few people knew who Clyde Edwards-Helaire was until he was named the starter for the Chiefs. And all of a sudden, everybody's like, this guy is the next Barry Sanders. Okay, go spend $1,000 on an RPA. Meanwhile, if you want to get a collegiate RPA, it was a collegiate RPA, by the way. These collegiate RPAs of Clyde Edwards-Helaire were, before week two, selling for anywhere between $750 and $1,000. You can get a Patrick Mahomes collegiate RPA for about the same price. For about $1,100, you can get a Patrick Mahomes collegiate RPA. So basically, unless you're keeping that Clyde Edwards-Helaire as a personal collection item, you're telling me that your investment in Clyde Edwards-Helaire, either now or in the foreseeable future, is going to be worth more than Patrick Mahomes? Get out of here. I'm sorry. That's ridiculous. That's turning the hobby into baseball, where players are here 1 second, gone the next. And that's never what the hobby was. So it is great for flippers, that's for sure. I mean, it's great. It's great for people who collect, and for people it's better for people who sell. But it just doesn't make sense to me. I mean, it makes more sense to spend less money, $100 or less, on cards like this. Like, I'm spending $100 or less on these Drew Lock RPAs. And I truly believe, especially because it's a quarterback, quarterbacks hold value so much more. And I truly believe that Drew Lock is the future of the franchise. And if he's not, then I'm willing to take that hit. But even third-year quarterbacks who still have a chance at playing, their prices are still up there. Just because there's a chance. Like, Marcus Mariota's cards were going up and down. Every time he had a chance to play, you had a chance to sell your Mariota cards. So it's not like this is an investment that's going to come and bite me like, oh, I'm down thousands of dollars because my running back got replaced by a rookie, like by a sixth-round rookie. It just doesn't work that way with quarterbacks, because quarterbacks are in short supply. Running backs are all over the place. So, I don't know, keep that in mind when you're trying to do any of that stuff. But anyways, 21 of 25, it's a hyper. 21 of 25 from Unparalleled. Absolutely beautiful. Beautiful patch. I'll be showing you an even sexier patch later out of this exact brand. And it doesn't stop there. I traded for this one? Yeah, I traded for this one, and I bought this one. Yeah, come on now. Come on now. At a 99, triple patch with the ball and a two-color RPA with his auto fully on the card. I've talked about that before. His autos kind of go off the card sometimes or off the sticker, which hurts the grading potential of the card. Especially if it's BGS, they will grade it off on the auto because of that. So like even this would be like a 9 on the auto for BGS. But still, crazy. The card market is absolutely nuts right now. And if you got in on it early, you're reaping the benefits right now. If you purchased Clyde Edwards-Helaire cards 2 weeks before the season started, then you are rolling in the money right now. But if not, then you might be the one who is buying them right now for a crazy price. Ridiculous. Anyways, moving on, I actually have some packages here. I left it in the package, but it seems like these packages, look at this, the packages are sticking together. There we go. Okay, I'm gonna open the one on top that was causing all the sticky problems first. This is the smaller one. This is I had to edit that out because I accidentally showed the address on the front of it. Don't want to give out anybody's address on a live video, but any video at all. This was packaged pretty well. It is from this year's Mosaic Football. Yes, the only Mosaic Football card I own. Can't find them in stores. And if you could, then you'd be a millionaire because people are buying them at $95 each blaster box. You buy them for $20, resell them for $95. It's not that hard. Problem is, you got to find them. Drew Lock, 2020 Mosaic Swagger insert. These are kind of hard to find. And this is the silver version of it. So it will say Prism on the back. And it is just crazy nice. So I kind of had to have it. Spent like $20 on it, which is feels so strange. Spending $20 on a second year insert of a quarterback that a lot of people think is not going to do anything. This is like spending $20 on a second year Blake Bortles. But hey, Blake Bortles just got picked up by the Broncos. Blake Bortles could be the next quarterback of the Broncos. Better sell his cards now if you got him. But yeah, that it felt strange, but I had to take it because it was the cheapest at the time for that card, and it's just crazy nice. I kind of love those inserts. So call me one of those guys who buys a card just because it's cool. But yeah, that was one of those impulses for me. On to the real interesting stuff. This one is a PSA slab. No, it is not a PSA slab. This is what I was talking about with this guy over here. This is another one of those guys. I can get this out. And this is that nasty patch that I was talking about. Are you ready for how nasty this patch is? Boom. Oh my goodness. That is a beautiful three-color patch. Drew Lock, unparalleled RPA. This is numbered out of 75 impact. 25 of 75. That patch is so much nicer. But this one is numbered out of 25, and this one is numbered out of 75. This one looks numbered out of 10. This one looks numbered out of 75. So what are you going to do? Or maybe 50, okay? Because you see the seam of the patch. So I would say, if I were given the option and I didn't know anything about unparalleled parallels, I would have said that this one's numbered out of 50 and this one's numbered out of 10. But it turns out this is 25 and this is 75. That's how confusing these cards have become. Anyways, let me move this and this out of the way. I do want to keep these there, though, because they just look so nice together. Right? Don't they look so nice together? I can kind of cover my name a little bit because you already know who I am. At @bigc7_cards. Hit me up on Instagram. You know the deal. I got a DM, by the way. Like, I have one. Like, nobody's using it, but I have one. You know, hit me up if you're interested in trading or buying, or if you got any Drew Locks you want to trade with me. Let me know. Hit me up. Maybe I can save you from your investment. By the way, I'm buying all Drew Lock RPAs for $20 each if anybody's interested. Sell out now before you lose all of your money. Yeah. This is a crazy story, and I'm going to show you the card first because you're going to be like, deja vu, Big C, I saw this card before. And I got a lot to say about this, so I'm going to drop it here first. That is a PSA 9 Upper Deck Kobe Bryant rookie card. Yeah, we know. We've seen it before, and I'm getting a phone call. Kobe Bryant rookie card, okay? I showed this to you before, guys, if you've been paying attention to the channel, all 25 of you or so. If you've been paying attention to this channel, I showed you this card before. I bought it. I was so hyped about it. Guess what? I traded it. I traded it for the contents of this mystery box. This box right here, which I will not show the top of because it has address information. I traded my last Kobe Bryant PSA 9 for the contents of this box. Now you may be wondering, but wait. Big C7? Hold on. You're showing us a PSA 9 Upper Deck Kobe right in front of you. So what happened to the other one? Did you get it back? Nope. This is a completely different one. Nope. I traded for this one after trading this one away for this box. Is that freaking mad or what? So I traded for the contents of this box. So I traded this exact card, PSA 9, for this box, which I'll show you in a second. Okay? The contents are absolutely wild. Shortly after, I was checking the Sports Card Investors Discord page, and I saw somebody selling this. I said, hey, would you want to trade? He's like, sure, what you got? I showed him a bunch of stuff I had. I struck a deal, and I traded. So I ended up trading away the card and then trading right back for it, which is absolutely wild. I love, you know, you guys know me. I love good stories behind cards. This one is a crazy, ridiculous story, in my opinion, because I had never seen these pop up on that page ever before until I traded one and then found it again. Ridiculous. That's just ridiculous. And it, on top of that, it's the old it's the old label too. The old PSA label. Cuz now it looks like that with the yeah. It's the old style PSA, which so it's literally who knows? It could have been slabbed around the exact same time as the other one was slabbed. Crazy. Crazy stuff. Redonkulous stuff. Absolutely ridiculous. And now if I'm moving the Drew Lock RPAs out of the way, you better believe something massive is about to come. I'm going to show you the contents of that box, and I'm going to leave this one smack dab right there for what is about to come. Okay? Contents of this box are going to blow you away. This is what I traded for. Okay? Taking it out. Proof that I'm taking it out of this particular box. Y'all know I'm a big Devin Singletary guy. First card I'm going to show you, part of that trade, was a Patrick Mahomes. Mahomey. Focus, people. There we go. Let me turn off the... There we go. Had trouble focusing there for a second. Patrick Mahomes. Prestige rookie. Come on, man. Focus. Focus. There we go. Beautiful card. Perfect edges, perfect corners. It's about a $50 card right now. Let me take the tape off of it so you can see the whole thing. But this is a prestige Patrick Mahomes rookie card. One of those things that I love trading. And I love eBay sniping because you never know what you're going to find. And it's some of those things that you never know you needed it until you saw it. And you're like, I need that. So now I have a Patrick Mahomes rookie card. Go figure. Let me show you what else was in this box. Devin Singletary, base prism. Devin Singletary, base optic. Pretty well centered for this optic. It's usually a lot worse than that. And that's pretty well centered too. I didn't realize how good centered these were. XR, Devin Singletary. Unparalleled, Devin Singletary. That's a base and a legacy base. So I got some nice Devin Singletary rookie cards. Okay, now... let's continue. Consider this as if I'm opening a pack, and I don't know what's in here. I'm going to flip it over, and I'm going to show you the contents without showing you what's on the back or any of that. You probably saw what was on the back already, but that's not even what I'm opening this to show you. Oh, this is wild, guys. I never expected to have this card, and... at this point, I don't know how I could live without it. Well, I mean, I would just live, but you get the point. This is massive. Probably the biggest Singletary card I own at this point, which is tough because I have so many crazy Singletary cards. Terrell Pryor. Nothing. Behind here is the biggest card you'll see today, no doubt. And I'm going to be saying the words that I... been saying that I didn't want to say in my other videos a lot. One of one. Devin Singletary. Absolute monster. One of one. Devin Singletary. The full Oh my gosh, the full football lace, or most of it. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna try. Okay, I got it. It's there. And we're gonna zoom. Hold on. Hold on. Oh my gosh. I can't even. It's ridiculous how thick and chunky and thick and chunky that card is. It is so thick. It wouldn't fit in a 600 point one touch if they made one. It is absolutely ridiculous. It's crazy. It is a crazy, crazy card. I absolutely love it. I thought that the cleat card that I had of Singletary was cool. This is beyond cool. And that is not gonna be sold. You know? What's crazy is I actually thought about it at first. I'm like, I know a couple guys who would be really interested in this. And then the next thought I had was, yeah, me. I'm keeping this card. This is ridiculous. It is the most beautiful patch card I own at this point. I don't know how I'm going to, but I'm going to have to find a way, some way of displaying it. But it's ridiculous. I don't know how many times I'm going to say that word today, but it's crazy. And that wasn't it. I got this too. 248 of 249, a Singletary booklet auto. Believe it or not, these aren't that expensive, but I didn't have one, so I was like, I'll get one. Because why not? And that right there. Oh my gosh, guys. And what's crazy, even crazier, is that the corners, the edges, these are usually destroyed on these types of cards. It's in brilliant condition. It looks like the ball was used too. It's just, oh my gosh. I can't get enough of this. I cannot get enough. My thumb is not that fat, okay? It's just how thick this card is. Let me show you an example here. Let me show you an example. This is a standard top loader next to this thing. Holy mother of thick. That's thick. Oh my gosh. I am sorry you're going to be seeing a crap ton of big chungus today, because that is... This is the definition of thick. Like, if you look up thick in the dictionary, if you look it up in the dictionary, you're going to see this. Boom. You're going to see this when you look it up. And that, guys, right there, was the biggest pickup. Out of all the things I've shown you, that's what I'm most freaked out about. Out of all that, out of all of this, all this craziness, ridiculous stuff that I got. There, I said it again. Craziness. That was by far the biggest one that I picked up. So, wow. I'm still coming to grips with owning this thing. Don't know if I'll come to grips sooner or later, but either way, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you haven't already, follow me on Instagram at BigC7_cards. Make sure you smash the like button on this video. I put a lot of work into these videos to make you guys entertained. I'm selling a lot of this stuff, so make sure you hit me up on Instagram in my DMs, or you could hit me up on my email address as well and let me know, hey, BigC7, I'm interested in X and Y card that you were showing. How much you're asking for that? And I'll tell you, brother, a lot more than you're willing to pay. No, I'm paying. I'm fair, guys. So make sure you hit me up. Let me know. And thank you guys so much again for watching. Like, subscribe, hit that bell so you know when I'm posting videos, because I don't post a lot, but when I do, you see it, it's fire. It's fire, guys. I give that fire content. Like, you can't touch this content in fuego, Okay, so make sure you hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. I'll say it 50 times if I need to get you to do it. Thank you so much for watching, and have yourself a blessed and awesome day. Hold up. Yeah, I got a God, don't change with the season.